Hi guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. As per usual for today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys products that I picked up from TJ Maxx. I'm going to show you guys the vlog part, and of course towards the end of the video I'll show you guys what I picked up. So this week I think I went pretty much every single day, I will say. Most of the days I found stuff, but there was I think one day that I was like, what, there's nothing here, you know what I mean? And I also met this woman who keeps watching me. Her name is Emma. We were waiting online together, we were talking the whole time. She was so cute. I looked like shit that day because I did my makeup and I just woke up. It was a lot of fun to talk to her, but anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this and let's go shopping.
So we saw the Lorac Beauty and the Beast lipsticks here a few days ago, but I just found the Beauty and the Beast palettes, which I think is so cool. I guess these didn't do too well. I ended up purchasing this. I think I decluttered it though. It's $16.99. That's literally like freakishly insane. Like, I don't know why it's so cheap, but I'm so happy about it. Anyways, here's how the palette looks, like the shades. It was a palette that was hard for me to create looks with, but I purchased it initially just for the collector in me, and then I just kind of decluttered it because I'm like, nah, I'm just not really feeling it. But it's so freaking cool to see this here. I love it, I love it. And I don't know if you guys see here, they added a bunch more of the Life's a Festival palettes, which we've discussed in the past, I think 2 weeks. So I'll have that video linked in the description box, of course. But I love it that they're kind of like restocking, because like, this is such a cute palette. I'm obsessed with it. I see a few of these Big Tease mascaras by Buxom. I might pick one up because last week I only found one and I didn't know if somebody probably opened it up. But now I see two here. I see one chilling right over there, another one right over there, so I might get it. I see this Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place Makeup. What is this, a foundation? It's in the shade medium. Here's how it looks. I actually have never seen this in my life, so I'm not even sure like what this is, if it's a foundation. I'm assuming it kind of is. I think I'll look up reviews online to see like, you know, what it does for the skin, but this is retailing for $14.99, which I think is pretty cool, and I only found one of these guys. Okay, then this is really exciting. I found a few of these Stila Shimmer and Glows. I wish these were the Glitter and Glows because I like that formula much more, but I still might go ahead and pick this up. I found it in two shades. So we have this really nice purpley kind of color, and then this shade, which is called Freedom. It's a beautiful blue. So let me see how these guys look. Oh my gosh, so freaking pretty, especially this blue, which I don't think I'll wear a ton, but like, I need this in my life because I need to have a whole collection of them, especially considering the fact that they're only, what, $7.99? That's an absolute steal. On Sephora's site, these are, I think, $24, which is insane. I really have to start using these because they are really pretty on the eyes. I'm so excited for these finds. I randomly just found three, like, what? And then I also found this, which I just found one of. I've seen like one or two of these guys in the past year as well, but I haven't seen like this trio. I don't think I'm gonna pick it up. These are not my shades at all, and I totally know I'm never gonna be able to create a look just using this. But it's the Smashbox Photo Edit Eyeshadow Trio in the Style Repost. And this is $7.99. Really, really affordable. If it would be three other shades that I know I would wear, I would totally pick it up, but I know myself. I know myself. I'm not gonna wear. Well, I might though if I use it in conjunction with other palettes, but I don't know. I don't need you. Moving up to this section here, I see a bunch of these Clinique Moisture Surge Extended Thirst Relief. I think moisturizer. I don't even know why these are here really, because it's a makeup section, but these are retailing for $7.99 each, which is very, very cheap for Clinique. I don't think I'm going to pick that up. We have some Stila products, a little bit more of the Too Faced Unicorn Life is a Festival palettes, which is insane. And guys, I almost died. I almost peed in my underwear. That's me. Peed in my underwear. Look at this. First of all. Here we have the Shade and Light Glimmer eyeshadow palette, right? Here is the Kat Von D Shade and Light regular palette. Like, you know, the one that was the most popular palette of life a few years back and every soul spoke about. I did never picked it up. And now it's here, which is crazy. What's going on? I feel like no one's talking about Kat Von D products, and like her cult classic favorites are just like here. I don't know. Anyway, there are two. So we have one right here and one here. I'm just like blown away because I really don't even know what to say. I don't think I'm gonna pick it up because I don't know. I feel like I have tons of these kind of colors, but to even see this here is is insane. You know what I'm gonna do actually? I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna hide it in my section. You guys know that I'm gonna think about it for a day and then possibly purchase it, because I don't know, I feel like I might be sorry if I don't buy it, but then if I buy it, I might feel like, hey, why did I buy it? You know, so I'm indecisive at the moment, because come on, this is a good deal. It's $27.99 and on Sephora, this is $50, okay? Okay, moving on to this section right here, I have, as if it's my store. There are a few of the CoverGirl True Naked Smoky palettes, so we have a whole selection here. I actually spoke about this in my weekly makeup video on Sunday, so if you guys saw that, you know that I own this already, but it's pretty cool to see. This is retailing for $3.99. Okay, so there's this kid crying here, but let's make it look like we don't hear him. Anyways, I found a bunch of these CoverGirl Outlast little duos. I think it comes with a lip product and like a glossy type of product as well. It's a smooth application. I remember when these came out years ago, my mother used to be obsessed with these, and it's like so old school for me, so it's kind of giving me like vibes, you know. And this is $2.99, so I think I'm gonna pick it up for the fact that it's really nostalgic. And I'm gonna pick up the shade nude just because I feel like it's the shade I'm gonna wear the most, and it doesn't seem like it's a matte finish. I feel like it's more of like a metallic-y finish, so I don't know how much wear I'm gonna get out of it, but I don't know, maybe I'll give it to my mother. She's not really into makeup, but maybe she'll be into this. I don't know. So I'm gonna pick it up. This is more of her shade compared to like all of these. Really excited, really excited. And for $2.99, bringing me back to those old school days, I'll take it. Just skimming over this section, I see a few more of the ABH subculture palettes, which we've seen thousands of times in the past. I'm not gonna go too in depth with these guys, but it's interesting to see that they're still chilling here. And these are retailing for $24.99. You guys, it's the next day and I am literally fainting on the spot. There are so many of these Sila Glitter and Glows liquid eyeshadows, as well as the Sila Glitter and Glow highlighters, which is so insane. I'm gonna kind of organize this so it can be easier for the eye, so give me a second. But whoa, look at this, look at this. I can't, I'm just like, I'm so happy that I bent down, because I was not gonna bend down. Okay, so I organized these guys right here. I think that there are only two shades. We have this one, which is a beautiful like greenish bluish color, and then this one as well, and this shade Painted Lady. And so when I was looking at this, I was like, why are these boxes huge? Because usually the Sila Glitter and Glows are these sizes, and I'm like, wait. And then I read it, I'm like, highlighters, I'm like, okay, yeah, I need this whole thing. I need multiples of them. And oh, and these are retailing for $7.99. It's pretty insane. I've never tried these, but I was really curious about them. The regular Sila Glitter and Glows are retailing for also $7.99, which is crazy because these are like huge compared to these. But let me see the two shades. I'm excited to see how they look. Okay, so first, so you guys can see, this is a Sila Glitter and Glow, actually Sila Shimmer and Glow, and these are the two Sila Glitter and Glow highlighters. So the sizes are definitely very different. I feel like these Sila Glitter and Glow highlighters could probably also be used for the eye, so it's like a two-in-one product, because I can't see myself using this shade as a facial highlighter. Maybe I will once in my life. But yeah, I don't know, I mean, for $7.99, getting almost double the amount and being able to use it for the eyes and the face, it's kind of like a steal. So I'm so beyond thrilled that I found these guys here. Like, literally my morning is made. I didn't have the best morning, but now it's made. Okay, so these aren't the most exciting, but these are the Revlon like sponges. They're retailing for $3.99 each. Honestly, I purchased this a few years back and they kind of suck. So if you see them, I would not recommend them. The sponge is hard like a rock, and even if you make it wet, like, it doesn't blend out for life. So for me, it didn't work out. But yeah, they're just chilling over here. We see two of these. This is so funny because I've seen this at Rite Aid, and then I didn't see it for like 5 years, and now I see it here, so I don't know. This is actually interesting as well. These are the Revlon sponges. These I've never seen in my life, but how much are they? $3.99. It honestly doesn't intrigue me because of how I feel about the other sponges that I just showed you. But the shape is so interesting. I've never seen anything like this. It looks like a thumb. I don't know. Guys, we have a little bit of a problem. So usually I hide my stuff right here, you know, like I hid it in here. But somebody took it out. So either somebody knows where my hiding section is, which is like, okay, great, round of applause, or somebody was just genuinely cleaning. And so I don't even remember what I took yesterday, honestly. I don't think it was that important, but I was gonna put these guys there right now because the line is sickly long. But now I'm thinking I either need another hiding spot or I'm waiting on this like 8 hour line. Okay, so it's the next day and I want to show you guys how these three palettes are the main ones that are here. So we have the Festival palette, the Shade and Light contour eye palette, and then the Subculture palette, which I think is pretty interesting. So these are the three main ones we've seen around the past 2 weeks, and then we have a whole stack right over here, which is insane. Anyways, the next few things that I found were from Maybelline, and these are the Better Skin foundations. We have it in three different shades, which rarely happens. Usually they're all in the same shade. I remember purchasing this like a solid, I don't know, 4 years ago, and I don't even remember what I think about it. I don't believe any of these shades are mine, so I'm probably not gonna pick it up. They're retailing for $2.99, which is so cheap. I don't know, now I'm kind of like, wait, should I just get this one? I think this one should be fine, but no, you could see my hand is so pale and this one is a little bit more deeper. I don't know, pretty cool. I see three of these guys here. Then I found this from Bare Minerals. I'm not sure what this is. Oh, I think that this is a bronzer maybe. It says the Skinny Dip. I'm assuming so, but here it says Ready. And here's how the bronzer looks. It actually looks really nice. I really can't tell if it's been swatched or not. A shade that would totally be able to warm up your face and make you look so sun-kissed. How much is this? $7.99, not bad. I mean, it's not bad, but for not knowing if it's swatched or not, it's kind of like, wait, what do I do, you know? We'll see about this one. Okay, then the next thing that I found was this, which was very exciting. Only one, but this is the Too Faced Beach Bunny Bronzer. I think that it's here because they switched up the packaging, so they're probably getting rid of their old packaged products. But I've never owned this, like, ever, and I always wanted to, but these retail for 30-something bucks on Too Faced site, and this is well swatched. Like, well swatched. It's not even my shade. I feel like it would be too deep for me anyways, but it's such a bummer that it's swatched, because even if it would be too deep for me, I'd probably pick it up anyway and make it work. But since it's swatched, it's kind of like, no, no. But I love to see this here. I hope I see more. And the next thing that I found was this. I only found one of these guys. This is the Blemish Remedy Concealer by Bare Minerals. Here's how the product looks. I'm not even sure what I'm showing you guys here, but it's not swatched or anything, which is really exciting. It's retailing for $5.99. It's in the shade 10, so a bit too dark for me, especially for concealer, so I'm not gonna pick it up. But if they would have my shade, I would totally pick it up because I'm curious to see how it performs, but they don't, so I'll try to do more of a scavenger hunt in the store. Also, I just came across this. I mean, I'm not gonna pick it up or anything. I've never heard of this brand, but I thought it was kind of cute and pretty neat. Like, this literally looks like a chocolate bar. It says Glamour Bar, and I'm sure they got inspiration from Too Faced, but this is how the inside looks. Like, with the back of it, but like the inside, you know? There's a matte bronzer, soft gold highlighter, a pinkyish champagne highlighter, and then like a bronzy highlighter. Kind of looks adorable. Like, it really looks cute. $5.99, I don't know. I kind of want it just because, like, it's just like, what is this, you know? I'm gonna think about it. Just skimming through this section, I see a few of the ABH contour palettes. We've seen these so many times in the summer. We have just three chilling here. They're $18.99, which I think is such an affordable price tag. We have light, light, and light. I actually used to own this, but I decluttered it. I thought it was fine. I wasn't never really obsessed with it. But when I remember when it came out, everyone spoke about it. I literally took a train to Sephora just to pick this up, and it's crazy to see this here now. You know what I mean? It's just like crazy how times changed. I love that they're constantly restocking on these guys, actually. We have a whole bunch of lip products from Milani, Maybelline. We have this brow highlighter from Maybelline as well. And then I wanted to show you guys this section. I kind of feel like it's so super messy and like dirty and gross, like this. And like, I don't know, like, is anyone gonna like buy this? Or just kind of like taking up space, because I feel like there's no point of it being here. Like, come on, look at this, look at this. And it gets even worse, brace yourselves. Here, I don't know. Let me just look at this. I'm actually curious to see like what the inside of it looks like, because it looks like it's been through hell and back. What? So it's the next day, and I see that they restocked on everything that we pretty much saw here the past like 2-3 weeks. But I just found this, and this is from the brand Models Own. They sell this brand at Ulta, and I think it's a UK brand if I'm not mistaken. But this is really pretty. It's called the Rock and Rosie Blusher Palette, the Blusher Palette. And I really do enjoy a lot of Models Own products. I haven't purchased products from them in a while, so to see this here is really nice. It's retailing for $4.99. And then here's how these shades look that are included. They're not swatched or anything, which is great. We have one cream and two powders. These are really beautiful colors. Actually, this one has a little bit of a luminous finish, and the middle one is a matte. But these are huge, like literally massive, probably the size of my nose. And I think it's really cool. I don't know, I might pick it up. Then we have this one here, which is a bit different. This is the highlight palette. It's the Sculpt and the Glow, and then the other one, like I mentioned, was the Rock and Rosie. So let's see how this one looks. It's interesting because these actually have more of like a blushy vibe than the previous palette. I would say the other one is more like highlight, this is more blushy. But in this one we also get one cream and then two powders. Really pretty. What? I was like about to leave, but I was scanning for the last time, and I'm like, hey, did I not see anything? And then I found this. Yum! I want to get it. This is a warm matte bronzer. It's retailing for $14.99. Ugh, a bit up there. Here's how the bronzer looks. It's brand new and it's super beautiful. I love that it looks like a camera lens kind of thing. You know what I mean? So cute. I don't need it, but I want it. I want it. I think I'm going to pick this up as opposed to one of these guys. Just because I feel like the quality will probably be for sure there with this. And with these, I don't know. Like, they look good, but I don't know if they're going to swatch well. And then also, I don't want to spend too much. I think I'm just going to settle for this guy. I'm really excited.
All right, so here's everything that I picked up. I picked up a shirt, but I picked up a different one as well. It's in the laundry, so I can't show it to you guys. But I usually find really cute tops there for, like, around 20 bucks. And I love them. So here's the first one. This was, I think, $16.99, $14.99, even better. I got it in medium. I didn't have small or extra small, so I figured it would be, like, kind of baggy. And that's the style anyway, so I didn't mind. It's really nice and soft. So I would definitely recommend you guys check out their shirts because they usually have really good deals on that. But that's the first thing that I picked up. And then on to makeup-y products. These are the Stila Glitter and Glows highlighters. I love how huge they are. Like, they feel so good and legit and, like, delicious in the hand. You know, I'm obsessed. But here's how both of them look. They definitely swatch a bit more sheer than I expected, so I feel like it possibly could be a good highlighter to wear to dab on and even maybe to use on the eyes as well. I don't feel like it's gonna be as pigmented as the Stila Glitter and Glow Liquid eyeshadows, but I mean, I don't know, I could still use it for the eyes, you know what I mean? They're really reflective, and so we have one that's more bluish and one that's more pinky on this side. And I think that they're actually really, really pretty. So glittery. Yum. The next thing that I went ahead and picked up was the Buxom Big Tease Mascara. This was $5.99. Very excited about this. Have another mascara in my life because you know that I need it, right? Like, you guys already know that. Yeah, here's how the wand looks. It definitely looks really delicious and fluffy. So I'm super excited to put this to good use because you guys know lately I've been just wearing mascaras without lashes and I'm loving the look. So yes for this. The next thing that I found was the Smashbox bronzer. I could not believe that I found this. Literally, it was like from God. He was like, yo, take this. This is for you. It wasn't swatched, nothing. You know, I love how it looks like a camera lens. I swatched it right over here. It's a super beautiful warm tone bronzer. And it is a matte finish. It's so soft as well. I think it was a little bit pricey for what it was. It was $14.99. I would have wished if it would have been at least maybe $12.99. But still, I think I'll get a lot of use out of this. And I don't believe I've ever used any Smashbox bronzer. So very exciting. So that's pretty much everything that I picked up for this week. I don't think it's a bunch, obviously not. But hopefully we'll have much better luck next week. I still do think that I found, like, good stuff, you know? Like, I'm happy with my selection. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video and enjoyed seeing what I ended up picking up. Obviously, let me know what you guys picked up from your local TJ Maxx or Marshalls. And I'm looking forward to reading your comments down below. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.